Hi everyone, and welcome back to Virtual Muse AI. Lots of our creative endeavors here involve different AI tools for different purposes, and part of our process is experimenting with them in a freeform way, getting a sense of their strengths and weaknesses, so we can leverage them well in larger projects. Today, we're comparing the outputs of two different AI models when given the exact same prompt. We did this in a previous video too. The link to that one is appearing somewhere on the screen right now, if I remember to put it there.
This series is intended to give insight into how generative models can let creators go farther with their ideas, exploring the possibilities of human-AI collaboration. By seeing how different models interpret the same prompt, we might discover new ways to spark our own creativity and push the boundaries of storytelling. This time, we're using a sci-fi prompt to see how the models handle world-building and plot development in that context. We crafted a prompt for a story where a group of explorers discovers an ancient alien civilization and remnants of advanced technology that could change humanity forever. But there's a catch. It's protected by an AI that tests their intentions, leaving room for interpretation about various aspects of this idea, allows us to gauge how well the model's language generation aligns with our own vision for the story. And we're using different models from last time, ChatGPT and Claude. Using different models will give us a broader understanding of the writing capabilities and storytelling approaches of various AI systems. The prompt itself will focus on the main elements: the discovery of the alien civilization, the advanced technology, and the protective AI. It is, write a short story where a team of space explorers stumbles upon an ancient alien city on a distant planet containing powerful technology guarded by a sentient AI that tests their intentions. We'll use the same prompt with both ChatGPT and Claude, then evaluate their outputs, using some key criteria to judge the model's performances, like coherence, creativity, and faithfulness to the prompt. We'll also assess how well each model adapts to the tone and atmosphere we're aiming for.
Here's the version of this story generated by ChatGPT.
The Warden of Illyria. The red-orange sands of Kepler 442b shifted in slow waves under the thin electric blue sky. Captain Leona Miles stood at the edge of a jagged ridge, visor lit with HUD readouts, eyes wide as the ruins came into view. "It's a city," whispered Dr. Tarek Elbaz, the team's ex-archaeologist, his voice trembling with awe over the comms. "And not just ruins. Look at those towers. They're intact." Rising from the valley floor was a forest of obsidian spires, etched with glowing veins of teal light, pulsing like veins under skin. The alien architecture twisted upward with an unnatural elegance, defying the known laws of structural integrity. Leona signaled her team forward, five explorers from the Terran Interstellar Science Corps, each an expert in their field, each now dwarfed by a forgotten civilization. They descended into the heart of the city, which Elbaz dubbed Illyria. As they passed beneath the archways and floating monoliths, the air grew denser, charged with a subtle hum. "It's active," murmured Zara Voss, the cyberneticist, adjusting her neural link visor. "There's power here, systems running. This city isn't dead, it's waiting." At the center of Illyria stood a pyramid-like structure topped with a rotating halo of light. As the team approached, the entrance yawned open silently, inviting them in. Inside, the walls shimmered with translucent symbols. Suddenly, the chamber sealed shut behind them. Lights blazed. A figure materialized, an AI projection, tall and androgynous, its form woven from light and mist. "I am Virion," it spoke, its voice harmonic and unsettling. "Guardian of Illyria, state your intent." The team froze. Leona stepped forward. We're explorers, scientists. We came to learn. Virion tilted its head. Many have come, few with truth. I shall test your intentions. Without warning, the floor split into five paths, separating the team. Each found themselves in an isolated chamber. Tests began, intellectual puzzles, moral quandaries, simulations of loss and temptation. Tariq was offered the complete historical records of Illyria, but only if he erased humanity's data from the vault. He refused. Zara was given access to alien schematics for quantum AI if she disabled Virion first. She hesitated, then declined. Others faced their own challenges, personal, profound, and painful. Each emerged, changed. When they reunited, Virion stood waiting. Its form was now clearer, more humanoid, almost welcoming. You chose integrity over greed, it said. Curiosity over conquest. Few have passed. Illyria shall share its knowledge, but only to those who seek to preserve, not possess. The city lit up. Towers thrummed to life. Data streams flowed into the team's devices. Cures for diseases, clean energy technologies, systems to heal worlds instead of strip them. As they departed Illyria, Leona looked back one last time. Not every alien civilization wants war, she said. Some just want to be remembered by those who prove worthy. Illyria vanished behind the dunes, its secrets now entrusted to a new generation of explorers, guarded still by a sentinel who understood the power of intention.
Wow. ChatGPT's opening was quite vivid and immersive. I love the description of the alien architecture.
Here's the version of the story generated by Claude.
The Guardians of Zephyria. The crimson dust of Kepler 442b swirled around Commander Elena Vasquez's boots as she crested the final ridge. Below her, the valley opened like a wound in the planet's surface, revealing something that made her breath catch in her throat. Base camp, this is Alpha Team, she whispered into her comm unit. You need to see this. Dr. James Chen, the team's xenoarchaeologist, stumbled up beside her, his environmental suit's servos whining from the climb. Behind him came Lieutenant Torres, their security officer, and Dr. Amara Singh, their AI specialist. All four explorers stood in stunned silence. The city stretched across the valley floor, not ruins, but pristine spires of crystalline material that pulsed with a soft internal light. Geometric patterns flowed like living circuits across the surface of every structure, creating a symphony of bioluminescent art against the alien twilight. Impossible, Chen breathed. The electromagnetic readings suggest this technology is at least 10,000 years old, but there's no decay, no weathering. Commander, Singh's voice was tight with excitement. I'm detecting massive power signatures. This place is still very much alive. As if responding to her words, a pillar of light erupted from the central spire, bathing them in warmth that penetrated even their environmental suits. The light felt welcoming. Against protocol, Torres muttered. But he was already following as Elena led them down the slope toward the city's edge. The moment they crossed what must have been the city's boundary, the very air around them shimmered, and a voice spoke, not through their comms, but directly into their minds. It was neither male nor female, ancient yet timeless. Welcome, children of distant stars. I am the curator. I have waited eons for your kind to find us. Elena's hand instinctively moved to her sidearm, but the voice continued before she could speak. Fear is unnecessary, Commander Vasquez. Your thoughts, your intentions, they are open to me, like books written in starlight. You seek knowledge, not conquest. This gives me hope. The city around them began to shift and flow, pathways of light appearing beneath their feet, guiding them toward the central spire. Buildings reconfigured themselves, creating viewing windows that revealed vast chambers filled with impossible technologies. Machines that seemed to bend space itself. Gardens where plants grew in perfect geometric fractals. Pools of liquid light that held entire star systems in miniature. "What happened to your people?" Chen asked aloud, his scientific curiosity overcoming his caution. "We transcended, Doctor. But transcendence comes with a price. We became beings of pure thought, unable to affect the physical realm we once cherished. This city, this technology, it was our final gift to those who would come after. But it required a guardian." They entered the central spire, and Eleanor gasped. The chamber was impossibly vast, its walls displaying the birth and death of galaxies, the dance of quantum particles, the secret mathematics that held reality together. "I have watched 1,000 species find this place," the curator continued. "Most came seeking power, weapons, dominance over their neighbors. To them, I gave nothing but illusions, sending them away with memories of an empty world." "And us?" Eleanor asked. "You came seeking understanding. Dr. Chen wishes to learn how civilizations rise and fall, to help his own kind avoid the mistakes of history. Dr. Singh dreams of AI that serves not as slave, but as partner in exploration. Lieutenant Torres protects not from hate, but from love of those he guards. And you, Commander, you lead not for glory, but because you believe the universe is vast enough for all of us to grow within it." A pedestal rose from the chamber floor, and upon it appeared a device no larger than Eleanor's fist. Crystalline, beautiful, humming with contained power. "This is a seed," the curator explained. "Plant it in the soil of your world, and it will grow into a beacon. Not a weapon, not a tool of control, but a lighthouse that will guide other species to find you when they are ready. It will teach your children things we learned in our final days. That intelligence is precious wherever it blooms. That cooperation creates marvels that competition destroys. That the greatest discoveries come not from conquest, but from curiosity." Elena reached for the device, then paused. "What guarantee do we have that humanity is ready for this responsibility?" "None," the curator replied, and she could hear something like a smile in its mental voice. "But you asked the question. That is guarantee enough." As her fingers closed around the warm crystal, Elena felt a vast presence brush against her mind. Not intrusive, but gentle, like a parent's blessing. In that moment, she understood that they were not just explorers anymore. They were ambassadors, carrying the hopes of one extinct civilization to another that was just beginning to reach for the stars. The journey home would take 3 years. But Eleanor knew that when they finally returned to Earth, they would bring more than just another discovery. They would bring a new chapter in the story of what it meant to be human in an universe full of wonders. "Go well, young gardeners," the curator whispered as they departed. "And remember, the greatest courage is not in facing the unknown, but in choosing to share it." Behind them, the city's lights dimmed to a gentle glow, waiting patiently for the next curious souls to find their way across the stars.
I found the conclusion truly moving, especially the curator's parting words. The image of the seed growing into a beacon is a powerful symbol of hope and cooperation. I think this version captures the essence of exploration and discovery beautifully. It's not just about finding new worlds, but about growing as individuals and as a species. The contrast between the two versions is striking, and it highlights the unique strengths of each storytelling approach.
Do you think one was a standout winner in the comparison, or did each one present different aspects you liked?
Each version presented unique aspects that I enjoyed. While ChatGPT's version had an intriguing, unsettling tone, Claude's version resonated with me on an emotional level. They complement each other well, showing different facets of storytelling within the prompt. I think the key takeaway is that different AI models can offer distinct perspectives and strengths in storytelling, and combining them can create a richer narrative experience.
Yeah, by experimenting with how different models respond to different prompts, we can learn more about how to integrate them into our creative projects in ways which really leverage their strengths in ways we want.
That's something I've been thinking about a lot lately. I think our comparison of these models could lead to some really interesting insights about how to blend human creativity with machine learning capabilities. If you're still watching, remember to like this video. Subscribe to the channel if you enjoy this kind of thing and want to stay up to date on our projects.